guys, and welcome back to another Lost Bits video right here on Tetra Bay Gaming, the series where we explore video game content that goes unused, altered, or normally unseen. And I got a pretty quick one coming at you this time. The rehydrated remake of Battle for Bikini Bottom just came out a few days ago as I make this video, and already several pretty interesting things have been found in the game. This is by no means a definitive Lost Bits for this game, but after the amazing support you guys have shown for the last SpongeBob video, I thought I'd whip this mini Lost Bits up quickly. And yeah, if you haven't yet seen the Lost Bits on the original version of this game, do check it out either before or after watching this so you can get some more context for a few things we'll talk about. And oh yeah, quick shameless plug, be sure to check out my second channel, Tetrabit Plus, where I upload more gameplay videos and such, like I just uploaded a video about Call of Duty Zombies in Bikini Bottom. I'll have it linked for you down at the top of the description below. Anyways, fellas, with all of that said, go grab your square underwear, it's time to find a few rehydrated Lost Bits. Alright, first up, a few secrets that are hidden away and are normally unseen by the player. Since Battle for Bikini Bottom starts out in SpongeBob's pineapple, let's begin there. So in my Battle for Bikini Bottom Lost Bits video, I mentioned how there were two shelves that were left over just outside the walls of SpongeBob's kitchen. One here with a barrel on it, and the other here with some boxes on top and spatulas hanging below. Well, both of these are back once again, basically in the same spot too. They both appear to have been rehydrated, so to speak, so clearly the developers knew about these if they made the effort to enhance them. Also, thankfully there's a proper skybox here this time, so it's not nearly as trippy. Strangely enough though, while the shelf with the boxes appears fully textured, the one with the barrel seems to be defaulting to some checkered asphalt texture instead. And as weird as that may be, if we zip around some more, after seeing that all the other rooms in SpongeBob's house are also rendered in the distance here, there's this strange, large, rectangular prism rocking that same dark gray checkered texture. Honestly, no idea why this is here. Then next, also like I discussed for the original version where Barnacle Boy was found inside the Mermalair computer and is actually the object that the player interacts with, here too, Barnacle Boy once again makes an appearance, though it's a bit different. Here, Barnacle Boy is no longer textured, he is seen T-posing, and to top things off, he's also standing in some yellow cube. Haven't seen those before. And also unlike the original, in which Barnacle Boy would react to the player interacting with the computer, here the model doesn't seem to react at all. It's pretty strange why both of these instances return in this remake. I guess you could argue that maybe the developers were trying to keep it as close to the original as possible, including the hidden things, but this just isn't the case in other areas. Like in the Flying Dutchman's graveyard, the duplicate sunken ship isn't there anymore, as aren't the duplicate duplicatotrons like here in Sand Mountain, and the tikis found behind the chalet here are gone as well. However, a hidden Patrick can now be found close to this area who is used for a split second during the cutscene after completing Squidward's mission here. Oh, and one thing I didn't mention in my previous video on the original game is that there was a purple shiny object found hidden under Mrs. Puff at the start of the Rock Bottom stage. Well, this too returns in the rehydrated remake, but it's now a static object, once again with that dark gray default texture. Anyways, I digress. My point is, why would many things not be brought back, but the shelves, the shiny object under Mrs. Puff, and Barnacle Boy were? My only guess is that maybe the developers felt these were secrets that were well known enough to be re-implemented or something. Then next, for some newly found oddities for this version of the game, right near SpongeBob's pineapple at the start of the game here, is actually a sign hidden just underground right here under this target. Now this is actually the object that triggers the reminder to activate this button, press X dialogue. Similarly, there's another sign under these tikis here, which also triggers a similar text boxed prompt. It's a pretty interesting way of handling these text prompts, I'd say. Also, while exploring here with a debug camera, I noticed these two little nubs in the sand here. And turns out these are actually the horns of one of those fire-breathing inflatable dragon fellas hidden away under the sand here. Then moving on to Shady Shoals, inside, just under the TV here, we can see some wiggling antenna. And yep, who else but Plankton is found just under the floorboards. It's kind of weird. Also in this area, just outside of the rest home, is a basic looking set of a downtown Bikini Bottom section with Plankton once again. And this is actually all here just for the cutscene that can be viewed if interacting with the TV there. It's pretty neat, and I think it looks leagues better than it did in the original. Next, also in Bikini Bottom, here at the movie theater, just inside is a hidden and normally unobtainable sock. Interestingly enough, if you do manage to fandangle your way inside, you can still collect it, and if all 8 of the other socks in the area are collected, you can actually have a total of 9 out of 8 socks in the area. Now obviously this isn't intentional. Just like the underground sign, it's strange this was left over here. I mean, perhaps this was just the developers testing placement, or who knows, maybe there was a scrapped segment planned around the outside of the theater here in which you would have been rewarded with the sock. Alright, next, so far there have only been 2 leftover unused models that have been documented. First is this police vehicle, it's very likely this was planned to have been seen near the police station. And then secondly is what appears to be leftover geometry data from the original game's Bikini Bottom. Based on the file name, it looks like this was marked for deletion, but I guess someone forgot to do so, likely since this was misplaced amongst the files for Sandy's Tree Dome. And for the last stop of this video, there are a total of 6 unused maps that I have so far found left over in the game's files. And thankfully, they're all accessible, and, well, at least 3 of them are notable. So, let's get to them. First up is an area listed as Battle Arena. Right away, as we load in, we can quickly realize this map is one for enemy testing. Throughout the area, we can see doors labeled for every basic enemy in the game, from fodder robots, to hammers, to even monsoons. And interestingly, each of these doors has an animated model of each of the enemies, but they are flattened almost entirely. This reminds me of the characters in the Game & Watch stages in Super Smash Bros. They look 3D from the front, but from the side, not so much. Anyways, each room here for these enemies also contains a Duplicatotron that will keep spawning them in, and these Duplicatotrons are actually indestructible here. And lastly for this area, at the end of this large hallway is this also large door featuring Squidward's large mug. After opening up this door, one of each type of basic enemy can be found here just standing there, menacingly. Here, unlike the other enemies in this map, these ones, lined up by height, can't be destroyed or really interacted with at all. Some, like this slick at the end here, don't even have any collision at all. Now you guys know how much I love test rooms, and this one is certainly no exception. And also related to this stage, there is Battle Arena props, Battle Arena AI, and Battle Arena gameplay. AI and gameplay are, as far as I see, the same as the regular Battle Arena map, just no floor, and then AI lacks any sort of wall altogether, as each enemy just falls with SpongeBob. Now props is a bit different though, as here there are only some green walls present, not much else to talk about here. Then moving on, next we got SpongeBob Dream underscore 5. And yep, this is the map from the scrapped Patrick's Dream segment from the original game. Surprisingly, this version is far from rehydrated. It's completely textureless, the collision is wonky at best, like here I got trapped in this straw. The spoon here doesn't move like in the original, this lacks the falling onion and pickle slices that would hurt you, there's no lineup of NPCs, and it seems like this stage is just too big as several jumps are seemingly impossible to make without cheats. I'm honestly surprised this wasn't one of the unused things that was added into this remake as the developers had touted. But since this map is left over, I guess maybe the decision to add it was on the table at some point, but judging by the quality of this map, I'd say the decision to not include it must have been made pretty early in development. And then lastly, we have Chum Bucket Lab 1. And once again, this deals with another thing I mentioned in my previous video, the unused boss fight phase with Robo SpongeBob, in which he would have inflatable anchor arms, and the player would have had to throw rocks at them as Patrick. Anyways, in this unused leftover level, once again, the area is completely untextured. Notable things here include Squidward and Sandy chilling on the edge here, with Sandy popping a nice T-pose, and oh yeah, these guys. Yep, not one, but two T-posing textureless models of anchor-armed Robo SpongeBobs can be found just outside the Chum Bucket's boundaries here. Pretty creepy. Now these are some big fellas, and surprisingly, they're actually still modeled on the inside, as seen in the original game. And additionally, there's also this model of the rubble that was supposed to be thrown at them in the battle phase. Now, just like the Patrick's Dream sequence, this fight is another one that I'm pretty disappointed that it wasn't added in, at least not in the way that many of us were expecting. The Patrick's Dream stage, the unused SpongeBob fight, and even the scrapped Robo Squidward boss all seem to have been reimagined for the multiplayer mode in this remake. Now, they're in the game, which is great, and even the slices of onions return here too, but I don't know, it's just not the same. I feel like these unused bits kind of lost their meaning by being added in this way. I mean, I get that the developers didn't want to change the original experience or whatnot, but I don't know, I don't think many people would have complained if these rather small segments had been added in as originally intended. But who knows, maybe eventually there will be an update to the game or a way to load these sequences in or something will be discovered. And that would be pretty awesome. Anyways guys, with that wraps up this short mini Lost Bits video on Battle for Bikini Bottom Rehydrated. Be sure to like the video if you enjoyed, subscribe, check out the original SpongeBob Lost Bits video by clicking on the card right here, and also consider becoming a channel member by clicking the join button down below. Anyways, thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you in a bit.